Sydney has saved the best till last. The King and Queen greeted beside a sparkling harbour and met by huge crowds at the Opera House.
The royal couple has just finished a packed schedule from the city to Parramatta, meeting kids, community leaders, even sheepdogs. Our team has everything covered with Chief Reporter Chris Reason leading us off.
At the Opera House, a standing ovation for the King and Queen on the final day of their quick hit tour.
I just thanked her for bringing joy and happiness into my King's life, and she said thank you.
This farewell moment couldn't stand in more stark contrast to Their Majesty's low-key arrival 5 days ago in pouring rain.
Just standing here for hours.
Smiley.
Given a flyover farewell. With Charles and Camilla conducting a naval fleet review, the King this week was made an honorary admiral of the Australian fleet. Today, he got to inspect the collection of frigates, mine hunters and destroyers, knowing all of them bore his title, HMAS, His Majesty's Australian Ships. The last sovereign to tour the Opera House is Mother the Queen, 2006. Far more controlled, no crowd interaction. This monarch doing things differently.
King Charles had started his day by swapping the crown for a hard hat, giving some high vis to sustainable housing issues. And jobs for youth, like this plumbing apprentice.
Never get a good plumber.
Then, from construction to cancer, the Melanoma Institute. Welcomed by Australians of the Year, Georgina Long and Richard Scolia, with their world-first work for cancer cures.
Adam is what we call one of our long-term survivors.
From the King, whose own cancer therapy is on hold on tour.
And the treatment isn't too bad, is it?
Understated and understanding. He said very little, but that seemed to say a lot. He was given the SunSmart message.
Slip, slop, slap.
And an Akubra as well.
Broad-brimmed hat.
The Queen's first stop today, brunch, but she helped to make it first, wearing an apron for food rescue charity Oz Harvest.
So what's the favourite?
Yeah.
Food-wise?
Yeah.
Oh, that's a hard question.
Today's favourite, recycled supermarket salad leftovers.
This is life-changing lemonade.
They gifted her a tiny teaspoon with crown and name engraved, then dubbed Her Highness
the most prestigious member of the Order of the Teaspoon.
Before Her Majesty flew off, a meeting with Pierre and his pet parrot, Caesar.
Hello.
Better behaved than the sneezing alpaca yesterday.
Give me a kiss.
Good boy, that's better.
Then booked in to visit Green Square Library, promoting literacy.
But then if you'd like to read something to me, I'd love to hear your story.
Meeting celebrated author and Republican Movement founder Thomas Keneally with a host of Australian writers.
What do you write about?
Then awarding prizes for the oldest essay competition in the world. But the biggest applause today, of course, was for the royal couple at Sydney's crown jewel, right beside the harbour. With such a short trip and so few chances to see them, the Opera House moment was always going to be a sellout show. And after yesterday's protests, it's almost as if Australians had rallied to offer their support. The King at 75, the Queen at 77, proving the royal touch still makes a mark in the great southern realm.
Let's go back to Chris Reason at the Opera House. Chris, with the action on the harbour now wrapped up, where are the King and Queen tonight?
Well, once that fleet review had finished, Mark, the royal couple headed home by how else but by sea. They took the Navy's royal yacht, the Hudson, across to the harbourside home of Admiralty House. It has been a very busy schedule for the royal couple, and they've been hitting all of their passion projects: science, sustainability, environment, education, service and sacrifice, among others. 27 engagements in 3 days and two cities, but by far, according to the thousands of people here today, this at the Opera House was their crowning achievement.
Chris Reason, thank you. The royal couple earlier visited Parramatta for an Aussie barbecue, complete with sheep, snags and a turn on the tongs. Annie Puller is at Parramatta Park. Annie, how did they see?
And the royal couple seem to be incredibly delighted by the display here, from backyard cricket to snags on the barbecue. Their Majesties certainly walked away with a true sense of community spirit, even taking home some Australian delicacies. A backyard bonanza fit for a king and queen. Welcomed with an ancient custom before a floral crowning, Western Sydney style. Parramatta's time to play host, and they did in a true blue Australian way. Taking centre stage were dogs Colt and Meg. But it was the sheep that caused the biggest stir.
The sheep coming around and then they start circling around the media.
The royal couple couldn't help crack a smile as Colt brought order back to the flock.
And he was actually able to pat the sheep. The dog was standing there, to pat the dog.
A taste of life down under.
How are the sausages?
Our local heroes ditching the togs for tools, putting King Charles to the test. Our local heroes, Sydney Surf Lifesavers, were supposed to serve up the perfect royal snag, but it seems the King and Queen wanted to get behind the barbecue themselves. But a taste wasn't on the cards.
If nothing else, they've learned how to turn the tongs in the exact way.
The monarch also walking away with a national icon.
I told him we'd keep him safe if he ever came down to Coogee.
Rare moments in the crowd too.
He's my hero. I can't say much.
Not the only one left speechless.
I felt like my heart was pumping a lot.
Among the 700 invited guests, community leaders, volunteers, charity workers, sports stars and celebrities. And ordinary Australians doing incredible things, including Inspector Amy Scott, who tracked down, confronted and fatally shot the Westfield Bondi Junction attacker. Then, one last formality, a few words from a very grateful visitor.
It's a particular delight to see and smell all the top tucker here today.
Walking away with a royal wave to mark the end, Parramatta's hour with the King was over. A historical day they will never forget. Annie Puller, 7 News.
Let's go live to Paul Caddack now, who's also at the Opera House. Paul, soon it's on to the next leg of the tour for the King and Queen.
Mark, that's right. The King and the Queen taking the waterway back to Admiralty House across the harbour, where they're probably going to need a rest tonight after today's cracking pace before tomorrow begins the next important leg of this overseas trip. Their Majesties will be flying out of Sydney to Samoa, travelling there for the Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting, or CHOGM. It'll be Charles's first as King. He'll be joined by leaders and officials from more than 50 different Commonwealth nations. The fight against climate change will be top of the agenda, an issue King Charles has championed publicly for many years. They're also set to discuss global security and the rising challenge of China. Meanwhile, Queen Camilla has plans to visit a traditional Samoan school and an event focused on ending violence against women. Like this visit to Australia, the trip to Samoa has been shortened due to the King's health. The royal couple are expected to return home at the end of the week.
OK, Paul Caddack at the Opera House, thank you.